Hello children, I hope you all are healthy and enjoying your e-learning. Let's start our today's session. After learning about the history of computer, in this session we will learn about generation. Dear children, we all have different generations of people in our family, like grandparents, parents and children. Same way, computer also have different generations. From UNIVAC to all-in-one computers, as you can see in the figure, we have lot of generations in computers also. You can also analyze from the figure that with each generation, the computer has become smaller, faster and more advanced than previous generation. When a remarkable development or growth achieved in computer, then it will recognized as next generation. Till now, the growth of computers recorded in 5 generations. So children, the first generation computers used vacuum tubes as processors. It was quite expensive, although its speeds was very slow. Even they were not much reliable and produces lots of heat. They used machine language, and we can say that ENIAC and UNIVAC was the examples of those first generation computers. Next is second generation computer, which was introduced in late 1950s. Those computers used transistors at the place of vacuum tubes. Size and cost little bit reduced and the speed improved. Still, they produce a lot of heat. IBM 140, Mark III are the examples of second generation. Now children, come to third generation, which was considered in mid of 1960s. In those computers, transistors were replaced by integrated circuits. They were also known as semiconductor chips. Those computers start using high level language like Fortran and COBOL. In those computers, size and production of heat reduced, but the reliability improved. They were able to perform billions of instructions in a few seconds. Monitor and keyboard also introduced in that generation. IBM 360, ICL 900 are the examples of third generation. After that, in 1971, fourth generation started, and they were used microprocessor at the place of integrated circuits. Thousands of integrated circuits were built on a single chip. They were accurate, reliable and very fast. High level languages like C, C++, Java were used in that generation. IBM 360, Macintosh, these are the examples of fourth generation. In 1981, personal computer was introduced by IBM, and in 1984, Apple introduced Macintosh. Furthermore, fifth generation computers are yet to come, like they will have artificial intelligence. Children, do you know artificial intelligence? Artificial intelligence means when computers have their own knowledge. They will be capable of learning and taking decisions themselves. They will use large integrated circuit chips as processors, and they will be able to recognize images and graphs and intend to work with natural language. That's all children. Now our chapter is completed. Children, read the chapter carefully and try to solve the back exercise. We will meet in next session. Till then, be safe, be at home. Goodbye.